£100 fine.
Thank you. Oh. Well done.
She's ill.
Mom, I'm driving. Can you believe it? They let me off. They actually let me off. I love you. Talk to you.
She's on her way.
Thank you.
sing. It's so lonely round the fields of Athene.
Veronica Guerin's writing turned the tide in the drug war. Her murder galvanized Ireland into action. Thousands of people took to the streets in weekly anti-drug marches, which drove the dealers out of Dublin and forced the drug barons underground. Her death during an emergency session of Parliament, the government altered the Constitution of the Republic of Ireland to allow the High Court to freeze the assets of suspected drug barons. That same year, the Criminal Assets Bureau, CAB, was formed and given the power to access and seize unexplained wealth from suspected criminals. Charles Bowden turned state's evidence and became the first person in Irish history to be entered into the Witness Protection Programme. Brian Meehan was sentenced to life imprisonment for the murder of Veronica Guerin, and his assets were seized by the CAB. Eugene Holland was sentenced to 20 years in prison for drug trafficking. His assets were seized by CAB. John Traynor escaped to Portugal and continues to fight extradition to Ireland on charges of murder. His assets were seized by the CAB. After a long extradition battle, John Gilligan was brought back to Ireland from England and sentenced to 28 years in prison for drug trafficking. His assets were seized by CAB. By the following year, crime rates had dropped 15%. Everyone in the Republic of Ireland remembers where they were when they heard that Veronica Guerin had been murdered on the Naas Road.
My love more dear than this life you are to me, your kiss more clear than the crystal of the sea. Please say fallen here, I'm lost and alone. An angel weeps, I hear him cry, a lonely prayer, a voice on high. Dry all your tears, the sun will rise on one more day. Hey. The years go by. the sun will rise on one more day.